Surely the mountains cried out in their grief. Sadness fell hard on the weak and the mighty. The cross overshadowed their hope and belief. But the grave was slowly losing the struggle. Angels were making their way to the stone. Joy was preparing to sing from the darkness, thus overpowering death and its groans. He who was dead is alive. He who was dead is alive. He who was dead.
It's Sunday, and all of the anguish and agony of the past week has surrendered to the glorious resurrection. This is the crux of our Christian faith. This is why we have a reason to rejoice. This is why salvation is real. He is risen, and life is glorious. But the journey to the resurrection was not an easy one. From the moment Jesus came to us as a child in a manger, He became acquainted with our grief, with our temptation, with love and loss. As he grew, I suppose he felt all these things that mankind feels. And that's why he came to us, to know us. Those who knew him best were surely witnesses to the struggles of a man who was God and a God who was man. I can only imagine that his friends stood by observing the miracles and love that poured out of him. Their hearts must have burned with joy and honor to even stand beside him. And for those who know him only briefly, they still understood the power and magnitude of this man called Jesus.
Some of us met him on a hillside. Some of us met him at the well. Some of us met him when we touched his garment. But all of us are here to tell. We are changed. We are changed.
We know it as the Last Supper, but they just thought it was dinner with a friend. As they broke bread, their hearts also broke at the revelations Jesus shared with them, that at the mere suggestion that one of them would betray him, and at the sheer love that he poured out on them like wine. "Eat of this bread," he told them, "and remember me." "Drink," he said, "and think of me. I have chosen you."
You have walked where I have walked. You have heard me speak your name. And from this very every
None of us in this room were in the upper room with Jesus and his disciples, nor were we there in the Garden of Gethsemane when he made the final decision that the Father's will would be done, regardless of the price. But every one of us can wear the crown of redemption, purchased by those moments of decision when God, out of his great love for man, chose the long, long road to Calvary. What is it to be loved, to know mercy so fully and completely? It is astonishing to think that the Lord of all heaven and earth, who created us, who knew us before we knew ourselves, would look down with us with the ultimate affection and say, I will die for you. This is love at its greatest moment.
Thunder shook the hillside. Darkness took the sky. Breath away.
On the third day of mourning, the third day of disbelief that their friend was truly gone, there was something happening, bigger than just those who sat in sorrow together, trying to find comfort in each other. There was a rumbling in the earth, a groaning, and the battle that was being won as creation moaned for the resurrection power to take the battle. Death defeated, life wins. He is alive. Yes, he was dead. Yes, he was buried. But now he is alive forevermore. Let the church tell it over and over so all the world hears the wonderful news that Jesus has broken every chain of death, hell, and the grave. And we are free.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Lord, in vain.